think about how you're going to mount. Do it real slow. You might hop in your stirrup first a couple times, just like you have. Like, don't think about getting on yet. Just do your hopping routine. You know? We almost want to be like, all of a sudden you're up there and she's like, is Katherine up there? Or like, you just hop there. Right. And you're going to sneak yourself up there. Maybe a little shorter hands on the reins today, just in case. On one side of him. There you go. Perfect. Good. Shorten your reins up and grab your night latch. If she trots, that's right. Try to keep her at that speed. And if she trots, I'd probably tell her to walk it first. There you go. Good. You're going to try to barely stay behind Danny or your her face. Yep. Don't really. Sit there for a second before we start walking.
Did you think she was beat this good?
Yeah, I didn't really quite think you were gonna hop on as quick as you did, but it went great, so it was fine. Okay. I'm glad she's being good so far. Alright, we're gonna walk again. I'm gonna walk first, and remember, just kind of jiggle your legs. Yeah, you don't even have to touch her with your legs. Just kind of like this without touching, and I'm gonna walk first, and then a clap. Don't lose your vocal commands. They're going to be a big deal all through her training process. All that lunge work you did with your vocal commands are going to start to pay off. There you go. Good. And let her walk at pretty much whatever pace she wants. At this rate, slower is better. For now. Good. And just wave your legs in a cluck. Yeah, that's probably a little aggressive on your legs for now, but that's okay. Good. More left brain. There you go. There you go. There you go. Good. Good. Now you're gonna do a little circle. Take your left brain, pull it, and I'm gonna help you by I'm gonna herd you like a cow. Don't over kick. There you go. Just wave and cluck. There you go. Good. There you go. And now straight at it. Yeah. it a success, or we can do a little bit of trot.
Okay, we're gonna try to.
Okay, but maybe go a little rougher than this. You ready for that? Okay, you need short reins on one hand.
Yep,
yep. And then I want you on my outside for this. So, and you need to grab your night latch for this.
Can you like get onto my inside?
Yep.
I guess I got it.
Yep, yep. I can do that. I'll help herd you a little bit. Okay. Now you just a little shake and a little cluck. And we're not going to trot quite yet. Let's get to the edge of the pen. And just be careful of these slick spots, you know. So maybe slightly off the fence. And I'm going to trot too.
Okay.
Okay. And just remember, don't wrap your legs around her even when you're trotting. See, that made her a little nervous, right?
But she didn't really, like, commit to anything. She
not tried. Yet. Not yet, no. But the good thing is your woe button's so good that you've got pretty good brakes for her not ever being ridden.
Right.
That's a good thing. So, okay, we're going to try one more time. Be ready again to woe her, just like we did. Shorten up a little bit one-handed. There you go. Just started a walk. Go. Get her back towards Danny. Left hand. There you go. Left hand. There you go. Two. Okay. That's plenty of walk there. Okay. And we're barely going to do a little stop. I'm going to jump first. Sit back. That's all right. Sit back. Lower.
Whoa.
I want you to pull her around a couple times with one hand like this. Make her give her face. Don't put your legs on her. And when she settles and gives her nose to you, just like you've done on the ground, a little more nose, a little more right hand. There you go. When she settles her feet and is soft, you can give her face back. Don't neck rein her so much with the left rein. You can. There you go. Now get back. Now get back. There you go. Good. Pet her. Do that same side again. Go lower on your right hand. There you go. There you go. And a soft left rein. There you go. Good. You're going to do that side one more time. You have your saddle in the middle. This stirrup looks a little shorter than your right stirrup. We'll do that different next time. There you go. Good. Good. Super good. Now you're going to do the left side. She may walk. Let her walk all she wants until she settles her feet. If you're real awkward in your arm, that means your rein's too long. So I'd slide down your left hand now a little bit. There you go. There you go. Good. If she ever tries to, when you do that, she tries to bite your stirrup, you're going to have to do something about that. Either kick her or pull her with the other rein. If you kick her, she might jump in the air. So that's fine. Just be ready for it. But she can't bite your stirrup.
Was she kind of looking at it?
She's kind of looking at it. It's normal. I've had plenty of them bite my calf and bite my stirrup. So one more time on the left side. Pull her around on the left side again. Good. Now we're going to, this is the last thing we're going to do. I want you to get either side her nose and just barely swing your legs and cluck and just time shorter right rein. Your right, your rein was too long. I'd get her nose before I ever flagged her off with my leg. There you go. There you go. Good. A little more nose. A little more nose. Yep. Just correct with your leg. Perfect. Good. Pull her nose around. Good. Let her settle and take your legs out. Good. Now pull her back one step with a wolf. Good. She's done. We're done with her. So we're going to prepare to dismount. And you're going to do this super slowly. You're going to make sure that your leg and your body doesn't hit the ground like 120 pounds when you get off. Okay? You're going to sneak down like a sloth. And you're going to make sure that your outside foot doesn't hit her croup when you swing it over. Okay? Go ahead and take your right foot out.